If I put the lady out there and she did, say, she tried to do 15 or more 400 meter reps, ran one, jog one, with a big volume, and the muscles aren't getting tired quickly, and we're able to gradually develop more lactic acid, and it's being dispersed right throughout the body, then we're going to get the desired result of a very low pH level. And that's what we want. Initially, that's what we want. We don't want the short, sharp igloid training at this stage. Now, if I got this young lady here, and I said, okay, I want you to run 5 times around the track, I want you to sprint 50 metres in every 100 metres, and you sprint 20 times running around that track, probably the average runner will probably only take 8 or 9, 10 minutes to do it. And now their legs aren't going to move anymore, because if we took our pH reading in the blood and the muscle, we'd find that the pH level would be very low. If we took the arterial blood here, we'd find a very, very different reading. Now, if we're going to get to the end of this period, we now have this development of the to its maximum, we've got to maintain it. Now, if we do hard anaerobic work, continue doing it, we're going to pull our condition down. If we don't do it, we're going to lose our development. So what we now have to do now is do what we call igloid training, the wind sprints, short, sharp wind sprints, 50-meter sprints. Try and get a low pH level of the muscle. We sprint the straights and float the bends. When you can't really sprint, just stop. There's no point in going down and saying, I'm going to do 12 or 20 or whatever it is. Just get out there. When you can't sprint, stop. We'll do that for about 3 or 4 weeks. Then we revert to the 50-meter sprints, bang, 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 50 meters in every 100 meters, sprint, float, sprint, float, sprint, float. And that will maintain your anaerobic capacity and keep you sharp without pulling your condition down.
In other words, we get on the track and we'll measure it out in 50 yards and 60 yards, 50 yards and 60 yards, and we'll sprint 50 yards and we'll coast 60 and sprint 50 and coast 60. If you're accustoming yourself to this sort of thing, I think it's better to do it the other way. Measure 50 yards out in the middle of the oval there on the grass and put a 30-yard marker there and a 30-yard marker here and sprint your 50 and then trot around. Give yourself a bit longer recovery and sprint your 50 again. Now, if you do 3 miles of these things, you're doing 48 sprints in a 3 mile workout, and it can be very trying. There's not much let up to it, and it's very hard. But what it does do, it starts to sharpen our body very quickly.
About by repeated fast-paced running. Many repeated sprints during these interval training sessions and the muscles adapt to the task.